an idea just popped into my head. How about if I get you all to see how good your motivational, leadership, and trust skills are so I can learn something about you and so that you can learn something about yourself as well?
Do I get a prize if I win?
Of course, Violet. There is a prize for this one.
Good. Then I got this in the bag. I don't think you have those skills for being a leader. You don't know me.
Neither of you, Violet nor Veruca, have motivation, leadership, or trust, so please stop arguing and let Mr. Wonka continue.
Mr. Wonka, do you really think you would learn from us? How is that possible that an owner of a successful factory could learn from us kids?
Well, why not? I learn a new thing every day. I just learned from you that you are not motivated and cannot be a leader. So, I cannot trust on you.
As long as Mr. Wonka treats me to some chocolate, I am in. Let me know what I have to do.
I'm going to observe all of you to see how your motivational part is. See if it's good or bad, and see if it's positive or negative.
So, Mr. Wonka, are you going to tell me what is going to be my task? Anyways, I want to be the leader of this group.
Why would you say that, Veruca?
I have the standard to be a boss, because I can tell them what to do or not to do.
I'm sorry, Veruca, but that's just not what a leader is made out of. Do you know what are leadership characteristics, or what it takes to become a leader?
Mr. Wonka, I have been listening to you and I can tell that your leadership skills are based upon listening to your employees, so that's the way you get them motivated for them to achieve their tasks.
Yes, Charlie, it is very important to listen to each of our employees here at the Chocolate Factory, because then we can learn how to fix and build as a team in order to produce this very specific chocolate factory. The relationship between the employer and the employee is very important, because if you have employers and employees who are working together, then more items get done. If they are not working together, then it is going to be less productive overall.
I heard chocolate. Can I get some now? Mr. Wonka, the chocolate that your company makes tastes so good.
Augustus, please stop asking for chocolate. Mr. Wonka, I wouldn't be able to do that with my employees because I'm always going to listen to myself. There is no point for me to hear their needs because I am the boss and tell them what to do.
There is where trust shows up. The employees never could trust a boss like you because you look just on your own side. The leadership must have both sides with his or her employees. The one to listen to them and the one to command them. Following this discipline with your own as a leader will create the trust within the workforce.